Welcome to the Watchdog Report. My name is Ed Ciffone, President of the United Taxpayers of Yorktown and Yorktown Watchdog. I have two sad things to relay tonight, is that Judge Tully, who was a former judge in the Justice Court of Yorktown, passed away April 21st, and that's where I work as a court attendant. He's a great guy, and sorry to hear that he passed away. And also Nick DiTommaso, my buddy, the sign, his picture is always out in front of the show. 2 years ago today, he passed away at the age of 83. So that's the sad news. Now the good news. We have a special guest tonight, Bruce Bendish. Bruce, nice to see you here. Okay.
Nice to see you again.
Okay. Bruce and I have been together in a long time at the Yorktown Justice Court. So he decided to run for district attorney for Westchester County. So, Bruce, this is your show. Why, let's first do a little bio. Okay.
All right, Ed, well, just so people get to know me, I'm a graduate of Villanova University. Very proud graduate in view of the fact that they're national champs in basketball this year.
Okay.
I went from Villanova to St. John's Law School, got out of St. John's Law School and was hired by Carl Bagari, who was the district attorney of Westchester County. I was there for 14 years handling all sorts of cases. For the last five of those years I was the head of the Homicide Bureau, handling all of the major cases in the county and trying the homicides. I then went into private practice. I've been in private practice for over 25 years in White Plains, mainly dealing with criminal cases, doing some civil work. As you know, Janet DiFiore was promoted to be chief judge in the of the entire state.
Right.
And it's a vacant spot in the district attorney's office. So I was approached as being overly qualified, having been in the district attorney's office, having been in private practice. I was asked to run, and it seemed like the right time and the right place.
Well, that sounds good. Did you get the nomination? You're the only person?
I am the nominee, the party nominee. We had a convention 2 weeks ago, and the Republican Party nominated me. I've been endorsed by the Conservative, Independent, and Reform parties.
Well, that's great.
So I will have four party lines to go in November 8th when the election is. It's the same as the presidential election. So we have a lot of work to do between now and November.
All right. So there'll be a lot of people voting.
It's going to be a lot of people voting. Obviously, you know, with all the national news of the primaries and everything, I'm sure that's going to be quite a turnout, so that it's important for me to get my message out to the public so that they can make a determination of who the right person is.
Right. We know that Westchester County has a lot more Democrats, but Bob Astorino is the county executive. So, you can throw that out the window.
Rob has done a great job. Obviously, right. Like you say, the Democrats are the majority. But, you know, one of the things that I've been trying to impress upon people is, even though it's a political office, really the district attorney position shouldn't be a party affiliation. It's really, as I've said millions of times, it's not a Democratic way to enforce the law or a Republican way to enforce the law. It's a fair way. You have to look at the law and do it fairly, equally, ethically. So the party affiliation really should not be the main concern.
Right.
People should be looking at the qualifications of the candidate, and despite any party affiliation, they should be looking at the qualifications and making a determination based on that.
Right. Now, how big is your job? How many people do you have underneath you? Well, you were there before, so.
I've been there, and that's one of the things that gives me an advantage, I believe, because I've spent 14 years of my life there, the head of the Homicide Bureau. In 14 years, you get to know the ins and outs of the office. But the district attorney itself is the chief law enforcement officer in the entire county. There's 120 assistants, all attorneys who work for the district attorney. There's 40 plus investigators, police officers who work in that office. There's hundreds of support staff. I mean, we're talking about a position that it's not a local town office. It's an office that has a budget of $28 plus million. Obviously, it takes a lot of experience, a lot of, mainly experience, and being able to allocate resources and use those resources to the best of my ability.
That's great. Do you have one primary objective?
Well,
have you looked at, because I know it's a big job, but
one of the good things about Westchester County is it has a very, very good district attorney's office. It's one of the most highly respected in the state.
Okay.
And I've had the benefit of, I was hired by Carl Vigari, who was a DA for over 20 years. I worked with Janine Pirro, and actually Janet actually worked for me when I was in the DA's office.
Oh,
so I've had a full range of being hired by one, working with one, and actually having a person work for me. So I have certain ideas where I think I can improve things. It doesn't take a lot of improvement, but people have to understand that with the changing times, there has to be a certain amount of change in the district attorney's office. One of the main things that I'm very interested in, and I think it's extremely important, is the drug problem in Westchester. In northern Westchester, Yorktown, we have a heroin problem. We've heard about it. Southern Westchester, we have a prescription drug problem. Those things have to be combated. We've had a lot of overdoses, with heroin overdoses, both in Yorktown, and we had one last week in Rye. One of the things that people forget is, they assume that the district attorney's office only deals in the courtroom, the four walls of the court. That's something I want to eliminate from the people's thinking. We have to go out to the middle schools, to the high schools, and impress upon these kids and the parents of the kids about the dangers of drugs. Not the fact that they're using drugs, that it would cause overdoses and severe physical problems, but they have to understand that we're talking about a situation that can ruin their lives.
Right.
They get arrested, if they get convictions, it damages their ability to get into college. It certainly damages their employment opportunities. So those things, sometimes I think kids don't realize it. They don't think about it. They think they're infallible. So
right.
it's the job of the district attorney to get out there and alert the people. The district attorney's position and the 120 assistants, it's not a 9-to-5 job. It's a 24/7 job. We don't get paid overtime. You just work when work is needed. So getting out to the schools, getting out to the public, and alerting the kids and the parents to the dangers of drugs is something that I think has to be done, and I think we can improve on that. I don't think the district attorney's office, even though it's doing a great job, has concentrated enough on that, and I think that's one of the things that
It's pretty silent.
I mean, they're enforcing the law, and
right.
when people get arrested, they prosecute and stuff like that. But the idea is not only to prosecute the drug dealers, but to get out, to get the knowledge to the kids so that there's no people buying the drugs. If nobody buys the drugs, then the drug dealers are going to go out of business. So we combat the people selling drugs, we put them in jail, we train the people who may be using or thinking they're going to dabble or thinking about it, and tell them about the dangers of drugs, and hopefully we make some impact on the drug problem in Westchester County.
Well, when you were in the DA's office, where were the drugs coming from?
Well,
where's it come from now?
Well, the bottom line is, no matter what anybody says, the drugs are coming from the Bronx, from the city. It's coming up. You see a lot of cars that have been stopped by the state police and going from the Bronx, going upstate, and they're stopped for speeding and stuff like that, and it turns out that they have coke or heroin in the trunk or hidden in the dashboard. So definitely the source is the Bronx. Now, I don't want to make Westchester the Bronx. I think people respect Westchester as being the people are more intelligent, they're more educated, they have a different way of living, and I think that we can use that to our advantage, because we can go to the families and we can alert them that, hey, if you see something, let us know. I mean, if you see things coming in, you see all of a sudden the neighborhood that all of a sudden strangers are hanging around and strange cars are coming, let us know. We can do something about that, because we're only as good as the eyes and ears of the public, and that's one of the things I want to impress on the public.
Well, when I was a police officer, it was exactly the same thing.
You
watch changes in your neighborhood. A lot of times it was the neighbor, son or daughter. was robbing their houses, you know?
No, I mean, you know,
that's the first thing I always ask, you know, who lives around it.
One of the things, you know, we're as district attorneys, we're in the courtroom, we're in the buildings. Obviously, we have to develop an improved rapport with the local police departments. One of the things that I've heard from the police departments is they're a little not upset, but they're concerned that there's been a slight breakdown in communication between the district attorney's office and the police. That has to be improved. There has to be constant communication. They're the ones out on the street. They're the ones who are doing the hard job as far as enforcing the law. We have to be able to give them the assistance they need. It can't be a situation where 3 o'clock in the morning they're looking for an assistant DA to give them some legal advice about a search warrant or about a search or anything, and they can't get one. We have to be available. We have to become more available. We have to alert the local departments. One of the difficulties in Westchester, you know, we hear about other counties, but one of the difficulties in Westchester is the multitude of police officers and police departments. You know, if you're in Nassau County, you have the Nassau County Police. If you're in New York City, you have the New York City Police. Here, just because somebody may be familiar with people in Yonkers, that doesn't necessarily help them when they're dealing with Yorktown or dealing with Peekskill. There has to be constant communication and a constant give and take so that all the individual police departments are comfortable with the assistant district attorney, so there can be that exchange of information.
Well, how many different police departments are there in Westchester?
Well, it's 43 departments, if you count the county and the state. There are departments, and obviously some departments are big. Yonkers is huge, county is huge. There are other departments that are smaller, and all the departments don't have the same resources. So that's where the district attorney's office comes in. If we're in a community that may not have certain resources to investigate crimes, we have to be able to assist them to get them those resources so that the case can be prosecuted. You never want to see a case that is dismissed because of a failure to provide the resources to a particular police department.
All right. Well, Yorktown's been pretty good. They have a pretty good rating.
Absolutely. And Yorktown's one of, but it's also one of the bigger ones for,
big one,
for,
right.
for 40
Northern square
Westchester.
Miles. Right.
So, there is a correlation between the size of a police department and their ability to get things done. Obviously, when you have a lot of people in the department, you can assign a person to become an expert in certain fields. Where if you only have, you know, 10 or 12 police officers, it's difficult to get them the expertise that is necessary because they're busy patrolling their area and not really capable of sending a person out to a class or to an academy to get some special training.
Well, we had mostly 51. Then as a tact activist, I said, we need more police. We need another shift. Everybody's yelling, your tax savings, because it made it unsafe for the police officer and made it unsafe for the town people. Well, so they did it, and they went to 58.
Right. Well,
so it was like another shift. Then what they do, they started the SROs at the schools. They pull 4 away.
Okay.
So now back down again.
One of the things that's important that, you know, people have to understand my position, I want to continue to have Westchester to be safe and secure. I want people to be able to go to sleep at night and not be concerned about their house being broken in or some violent act. My job is to prosecute criminals. That's the job of the district attorney. That's the policy that I would set, and hopefully all the assistants would follow that, because the goal is to have a safe and secure Westchester. We've been fortunate, like I said, the DA's office is a very respected department in the state. Right. I'd like to continue that. I think the fact that I have the experience and I've been to all these courts, you know, some talk about opponents and everything, they've never been to some of these courts. They've never been to Yorktown. They've been to maybe the county court in White Plains or maybe a Mount Vernon court, but they've never been to Yorktown. They've been to Peekskill. They've never been to Somers. They've never been to these places. So it's difficult for me to believe that they can understand the problems that the local police departments are facing, understand the problems the courts are facing, understand the problems that people are facing. Obviously, an argument can be made that some of the problems in Yorktown are not the problems that people in Yonkers face. There are different areas, there are different types of locations, so that some of the problems may be similar, but some of them are different.
Different, yeah, wow. Well, who's in there now?
Janet, as I said, Janet became a chief judge in the state. There's an acting district attorney, Jim McCarty. He's not running. He was the chief assistant. He's just basically holding the position open until November.
Okay.
And the winner in November will be the district attorney. It's kind of a unique situation this year because, as you know, the district attorney's term is 4 years.
Oh, 4 years,
but
okay.
Because she left, the 4 years is going to start this year. Normally, the district attorney doesn't run in a presidential year, but because Janet left and there has to be an election in November after she leaves, from now on, the district attorney's race will always be a presidential year. So that makes things interesting, to say the least. But again, it's as a Republican, conservative, independent, reform, it's my job to get the word out to the people. I'm confident that when people look at the qualifications of all the candidates, that I'm the highly and the most qualified. It's easy. If I have the respect of the judiciary, you know, if you go to most of the judges, they're going to say, hey, the guy knows what he's doing. He's been around the block. He has the experience. He has the ability to be a great district attorney. If you go to the police departments, it's a little too early, but I've been advised that I will have the endorsement of most of the PBAs, most of the police departments throughout the county. If you go to those people, they will be able to tell you about my qualifications. One of the things I'm asking people watching your show, is to ask the experts, ask the police, ask the judge, ask other attorneys about the qualities of the people who are running for district attorney. I'm confident that when people do that would help me. I don't want to be overconfident. I'm certainly the underdog only because of the numbers. But you know, I have endorsements from a lot of people, and I'm very hopeful that people will reach out, ask their friends, ask people in the business who would be the best person to keep Westchester safe and secure.
Well, that really sounds good. Well, this is a venue that you're going to get on. You go on to YouTube, and then it's
getting the word out.
Get the word out.
That's important because there are a lot of people. I mean, you can't believe how many people think that Janine Pirro is still the DA.
Still the DA.
All right, because she's on Fox News, Channel 5, she's on the Fox Channel. People see her and they call her judge and everything, so they still think that she's involved. So people sometimes lose sight of who the DA is. In an ideal world, we will prosecute crimes. My name doesn't have to be in the headlines. You know, we do our job. The local assistants will do their job. The assistant DAs will prosecute, investigate, do what is necessary. So, as I said, it's not a situation where I'm a political animal. I've never run for political office, even though technically it's a political position. I don't think a politician should be in charge. I think a person who's done the job, who has shown the ability to do the job and has the credentials to do the job, that's more important than some politician who has always been running or always been in the forefront of some political party.
Right, because I know the DA, ex-DA, she was a Republican and switched to Democrat. Now, when you come into office, what is your first job? Is to change everybody or to see what's going on?
Well, again, not to throw stones at other candidates, but one of the benefits I have is that I know most of the ADAs. I've been against them when I had to be a defense attorney. I've worked with them. So I know, in my opinion, the ones, the good ones, the bad ones, just like anything else. There are good doctors, bad doctors, good judges, bad judges, good attorneys, bad attorneys. There are good ADAs and some that maybe are not so good. It's not going to be a total upheaval. I think in any business, when a new person comes to the head of the organization, there'll be some turnover. But as I said, the district attorney of Westchester County is a very respected office. The only way you get that is having good assistant DAs. So most of the ADAs will remain. Hopefully they'll be doing their job as they've been doing, and there won't be any necessity to change wide-scale positions.
Well, I know in Yorktown, like, used to be every 6 months change.
It used to be that there was a turnover. People would become an assistant DA for 3 or 4 years and move on to private practice.
Okay.
Now people are staying longer, staying 7, 8, 9, 10 years, so that there's less of a turnover. When you had the turnover, obviously an assistant DA coming out of law school needs trial experience.
Right.
You're going to give the person the trial experience in the local courts. Not that it's an unimportant local courts, but if they're doing, you're going to train on a petty larceny, you're not going to train on a double homicide. So those people are getting their training out in local courts. Now, as you said, there has been less turnover, so they're staying longer, becoming more experienced, and what I've been told, doing a great job.
Yeah, I've always been happy to see those new people or the people that were in there, because they, it's like you said, it's like a team, They come in, they work with the judges together, they figure out what to do.
And again,
process goes quick.
One of the things I'm emphasizing is my ability to be part of that team, because I know what has to be done. For a person to come in and say, well, I've never been a prosecutor and I'm learning from day one, well, that's going to suffer. This is too big a job to be on a training exercise.
Right.
You have to know from day one what's going on. So if you've never tried a case, either as a prosecutor or as a defense attorney, if you've never been to these courts, if you've never been to Peekskill, if you've never been to Yorktown, never been to Bedford, never been to Somers, you have to have that knowledge. You can't just say, I'll learn it when I take January 1st, when I take over. I have that knowledge. And the other thing that people don't realize is, even though Westchester County has a very good district attorney's office, there are procedures in other counties that may be a little better. Now, I've had the benefit, being in private practice, of going to other counties, going to Putnam, going to Rockland, going to Albany, going to Nassau, Suffolk.
Oh, yeah.
I can see the procedures that they use, and I can compare them to Westchester. In most of the cases, the procedures in Westchester are as good or better. But there are a few procedures that I think need a little tweaking, taking the benefit of going to these other counties, that I would implement in Westchester and hopefully improve the quality of prosecution and improve the back and forth between defense attorneys and prosecutions, and the back and forth between judges and the prosecution. So those things are to my benefit, because I've had the opportunity to go to all these other courts.
Wow. Because I know that upstate with the smaller courts, they don't even have to be an attorney. In some places, I remember a long time ago.
Technically, to be a local judge, you don't have to be an attorney. But with the quality of the local bench in Westchester, and obviously in Yorktown, and all these judges, it would be foolish not to have a lawyer on the bench. One thing if you don't have any lawyers available, but obviously, for instance, Yorktown is a perfect example. We have two great judges, they're lawyers. Right. It would be foolish not to have lawyers in that position.
Right. Well, that's great, and they always had a good rapport with when you came into court. The best thing is you see a lighting up when you came in. I think that's a good feeling for you and for everybody, because they know who you are.
I would like to think people have confidence that I know what I'm doing. I know what the right thing to do is. The thing that it's always said, that the goal of a prosecution is not to simply get a guilty verdict. The goal of the prosecution is to do the right thing. If the right thing is to dismiss a case, then the district attorney has to do the right thing and dismiss the case. Every case is not perfect. There are holes in cases that have to be examined. Maybe some of them can be overcome and we can get a conviction, but there are cases that have to be evaluated. And again, the goal is not simply to get a conviction. The goal is to do justice. And if justice requires a dismissal, then a knowledgeable district attorney should do the right thing, should do the ethical thing, and dismiss the case if that's what's necessary.
Right. So you're the last word. Huh?
I am the last word, obviously.
Trickles down, and you know all the cases that are going on.
Yeah, and I have confidence in my people.
Step.
I'm not, as district attorney, I'm not going to be in every court, but I'm going to have confidence in my people that they will follow my direction, do the right thing, do the ethical thing, do what must be done so that justice is served.
Yeah. They have a new thing now. I just realized this week. that when you have an arraignment, you have to have a lawyer there now. Used to be all the time, you know, middle of the night, you know, now we have to wait.
Well,
for the court.
Again,
part is that a new change?
You know, part of that has to do with making sure that the individual's constitutional rights are protected.
Right. Okay, great.
You know, one of the things, again, talking about the things that we need to have a prosecutor available so that when the defendant is there with his lawyer, the people are also represented. Because
right.
it's important that we represent the people of the state of New York. So besides the defendant having the representation, I want to make sure that the people are also represented at all hours of the day and night.
All right, Bruce, this is like a commercial for you. Now, there's a couple of minutes left. Camera 3, you see the light?
Yes, I do.
All right, give it the best shot you have, why people should vote for you.
Well, there are a couple of things that, as I've said in the show, there are a couple of things that have to be considered in hiring a district attorney. You hire him because you're going to vote for him. There are things I want to do. I want to improve the drug enforcement. I want to do something about the heroin problem we have in northern Westchester, the prescription drug problem we have in southern Westchester. There are other things that I think are important, the communication between the district attorney's office and the police. And one of the things that is kind of a pet project of mine is, as district attorney, I want to establish a veterans court. A veterans court is a court that is designed specifically for returning veterans. As all of you may know, that returning veterans, people have been in wars, they have a 1 in 5 problem, that a drug problem, 1 in 5 returning, and 1 in 6 have a problem with some mental disabilities and trauma. So those people should be treated differently. They deserve the respect. You know, we have drug courts and we have DWI courts, but I think the veterans deserve the respect to give them a court so that those courts can be coordinated with the Veterans Administration, and if treatment is necessary, jail is not appropriate, let's get them the treatment. I'm 14 years as the United States Army Reserve. I was a lieutenant in a JAG unit, so I have some relationship with the military, and I think that those people deserve the respect to be treated differently and separately. So those are the things that I'm looking for. I'm looking to, you know, one of the other problems, we have identity theft. That's a major problem for the older people, Heritage Hills and people like that have been barraged with attempts to steal their identity, causing them problems, and we have to alert the public, get out there in front so that they're able to protect themselves.
Well, you got a full plate, as they say.
Yes.
Listen, I want to thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me, Ed.
And I wish you the best of luck. And maybe as it gets closer, we can do this again.
Absolutely.
Okay, and to the people out there, you've seen his email, see his website, please go on it, and vote for this man November 8th when it comes up. Thanks for watching. Listen, go on our website too, yourtownopengov, yourtownopengov.net, and you'll see all the information about the UTY and what we do to try to lower taxes. That's our main thing. 1976, so we've been around a long time.
You've been around.
So,
for sure.
Again, thanks again.
Thanks
man.
Very much.
Okay.
Appreciate it.
Thanks for watching, folks. Remember, you can see us on 9 o'clock on Saturdays at Channel 74, Mondays at 9:30 at night, and Wednesdays at 4:30. Or YouTube, Ed Ciffone's videos, and you'll see all our shows. Thanks again for watching. From the